New at 6 o'clock, heavy rain like this can back up storm sewers. And tonight, for the first time, area businesses, churches, and schools will have to pony up to some big bucks to fix the problem. This comes on top of the sewer rate increases for Northeast Ohio homeowners.
It's all an effort to fix an aging sewer system. News Channel 5's Paul Kiska joins us now. And Paul, I'm sure businesses aren't happy with this. And I understand suburban mayors aren't very happy about it either.
Those mayors are worried about businesses in their cities where people work and make a living, because as these business owners face soaring sewer bills, they could pass those rising prices on, even lay people off or possibly shut down.
Massive thunderstorms triggered severe flooding in February. New developments in old abandoned store parking lots added to the storm runoff. A plan to fix the region's aging sewer system and ease that runoff would cost home and business owners in 60 Cleveland suburbs an extra $40 million a year combined. Dozens of mayors have filed suit to challenge how the new fees would be imposed by the Northeast Ohio Regional Sewer District.
Those discussions have broken down.
Cuyahoga County Executive Ed Fitzgerald is trying to play peacemaker. Today, he had mayors meet with the sewer district board, trying to prevent this issue from going to trial in July, because cities and the county are spending millions of taxpayer dollars in legal fees over the sewer fee debate.
That means the meter is running on the lawyer's bills.
And some cities, like Lyndhurst, already spent $10 million fixing storm sewers. And new fees shouldn't blanket the region, says Mayor Joseph Cicero.
It should be taken into consideration that some communities have done work, and they shouldn't be penalized for the work that they've done over the years.
Even those cities that are spending money, they're solving their problem, but they're sending the problem to the neighboring community, and that's the problem here.
Ralph McGreevely represents apartment building owners. He says the new sewer fees would make one apartment owner pay
to the tune of about $450,000 a year annually.
Malls and shopping centers in Beechwood could pay up to $700,000 a year. Schools and churches would have to pay the new sewer fee. And some mayors worry businesses would leave. Julius Chach, executive director of the sewer district, sees it this way.
Well, what it means is that they're finally going to start paying some of their fair share of the water runoff that's causing all the damage. Right now, it is the residential property owners who are picking up the tab.
All right, after meeting all day with Ed Fitzgerald, those mayors and the sewer district just agreed to go to mediation before going to trial on this issue in July. Reporting live downtown, Paul Kiska, News Channel 5.
Yeah, that's a big burden for them. On average, Paul, what will homeowners pay if rates are raised?
Well, on top of all the other rising bills, the water bills, the current sewer bills, this new sewer fee, about another $60 a year.
Yeah, that's a bite.